And this one is he's not a lot, by the way. I mean, I'm always on him. Oh, there's a rule. So before I went and you know, shared this with me, that you know, I want to get a profile page-worthy picture of a pack group next to me. It's like, you know, like, but we're not allowed to. There's a rule as well, part of the Antarctica treaty system. When you see wildlife, you have to keep 5 minutes. And that's for your own safety, but mostly for them as well. You don't want them to, you know, to get shot. And actually, when they get shot, they also return aggressive on you. But mostly, it's also to respect the space. That one, they're fine. Yeah, that one will be fine. So, I mean, when we were in places where penguins are everywhere, right? It's hard to keep that rule. And so the guides and the expedition team would be looking at you mostly, not going to like, you know, or like, you know, pull or pinch the, because by then you can't help it, they will all be coming towards you. But they are very, they are not actually intimidated by human beings at all. And I asked this question, I wondered if that they would be used to it, to make me understand, or that they're just very gregarious and or maybe we just put a little bit like that in their eyes, you know. So there you go, this one. I just thought that I would show you, it's a very short one. They do that, by the way, I don't know whether you know, but penguins are the only monogamous animals in the animal kingdom. I know. So it's very endearing for me, someone who obviously had, you know, very bad history with the monogamy, but the story goes that penguins stay with their mate every time. So every season, they will mate, then the females will go and hunt for food. The males stay on to look after the eggs. And then the females will come back, and then, you know, and they would always try to find each other. So how they find each other is through the sound they make. So even in the colony, and then they will base on the sound to know where their mate is, because, I mean, they obviously can tell the difference now, we can't. But I was told that it's because of the sounds that got them to then reconnect with their mates again. So, yeah, really the cutest thing. And now I want to show this to you. That's right. They're all poop, actually. I'm serious. They're all poop. So, this is eyes, right? The green part is the, so the pink one is because of the change. So this, the pink part is actually poop. Right, the green part is actually it's poop as in just whatever comes out, you know, without any adulteration from the penguins. The green part is the bowel. No, the bowel. And so remember that, as we said earlier, with ice of this temperature, it never really goes hotter than to -4, -5, you know, that you preserve everything. So you see this landscape, you think, wow. I would not kiss the ground. Very, very much. Yeah, very, very much. In fact, I was convinced that I still smell a bit when I finished the trip and I was in Patagonia. But it's worth it, you know. It's worth it. Yeah, it's very strong. Very strong. So this is another, so this was a very, very cold day. What I wanted to show you was, I mean, it's blurry partly because it was so cold. Actually, taking photos there is really difficult. Because even just taking a few minutes to just, you know, try to sort of, you know, hold and whatever, even the professional photographer, it's just impossible to take the best photo. Because to take the best photos, you need to wait for the right moment, right? But your hands are completely freezing. And so a lot of photos, you kind of just have to go with the moment and see whatever happens, happens. I want to take this because it's how they move about. They glide. In the snow, the one on the left, that's what they do to get around quicker, more efficiently, okay? I mean, we all think about penguins as just gradling, and they do better on our, they're the cutest penguins, but they actually glide a lot on the ground. And so myself and my pandemic try to do that. We did, you know, move like, I don't know how they do it, because it's not like pure slippery ice like the wings you see in the ice skating ring, right? But we can move, but anyway, never mind, we try it anyway. So this is another one. So this is really still not one of the biggest colonies, but everywhere you see this. Again, all the big ones, people are saying, oh, so you get grass and flowers. No, no, this is blue. No. Again. Wow, green as well, yes. Yeah, so remember they don't get washed away. I think one of the things that, you know, touches me the most about penguins is that, other than the fact that they're clearly very faithful and committed, they're also very adaptable and very resilient. Many a time when we are actually passing by, the waves are crushing. You see a lot of them, you know, trying to jump off, and they would think about it, they would look down, almost very human-like, and then they would jump. And then when they want to come back, it's always a struggle for them. It's so slippery, and as they're trying to come up, another wave comes, and constantly you've seen this, it's getting quite meditative to watch. Yeah, still coming up, and going back again, coming up, and going back down into the water again, coming up, and all that. When they swim, they tend to do a little bit of flight. We know that penguins will fly. Right, but they do a little bit of flight in the waters. And sometimes they do it in, you know, in pairs or in threesomes, and that's really what I think the penguins. And then I wrote about it in my blog that no one can ever be really angry or unhappy when you look at a penguin. It's really quite difficult. Like,
really synonymous with Antarctica, with Ushuaia, all that.